Pepper soup is one of those meals that I believe to have healing properties. The amount of herbs and spices that go into it, oh my God, so many herbs and spices, and they make the soup taste so good. It is warm, it is healing, it is comforting, and it is ridiculously easy to make. So today I'm sharing with you Cameroonian pepper soup. How to make Cameroonian pepper soup. I grew up in Cameroon, and even though different people have their ways of making pepper soup, I'm going to show you how I make it. One always present ingredient in Cameroonian pepper soup is njangsa, little seeds that look like chickpeas, but they are very different from chickpeas. Don't get it twisted. They add creaminess and a very unique flavor to pepper soup that just makes it pepper soup. When you smell njangsa, you know that pepper soup is cooking. So let's talk about the meats. I'm using three different kinds of meats today, but you could definitely use just one kind. Don't feel obliged to use a combination of meats like I'm doing. Right here we have oxtails, beef feet, locally known in Cameroon as foot cow, and right here we have goat meat.
Now I'm going to wash every one of the meats and put them in a pot, a large pot, because I'm making a new pot of pepper soup. Feel free to have this recipe if you don't need as much pepper soup as I do. A nice big cozy pot. We need a really big pot of pepper soup.
So I'm going to pour in enough water because we want enough soup here. I'll add a little more. So let's talk about the spices. Right here we have njangsa, which is the spice that makes Cameroonian pepper soup, Cameroonian pepper soup. Ground white pepper, some ginger, one medium onion, a full clove of garlic that I have peeled, and some hot peppers, scotch bonnet or habanero pepper, a celery stalk, some Thai basil. I really love Thai basil for pepper soup because it has really great flavor. And some curly parsley. We also have some salt, of course, and bouillon powder, which replaces Maggi that is typically in Cameroonian dishes. This does the job just like Maggi. So you can either use the powder or you could use the cubes. It's the same thing. Our meat is boiling, so I'm going to go ahead and skim all that, I don't even know what to call it, all that thing you see on top. I was going to say skunk, but I realized that I've lost the English word for it. Anyway, all of this nyama nyama, I don't want it. So I'm going to take all of that out. And one thing to note about the meat is that if you have some cuts of meat that are tougher than others, you start by cooking the tougher cut of meat first. Then you gradually add the meat according to the toughness. But I combine all my meats and cook them at the same time because I have done this combination several times and I find that they cook at about the same time, so that's fine. They are going to get ready at about the same time, so that's fine. They are all really tough cuts of meat, but they make really tasty pepper soup. Now that I have all of that foamy thing out, I'm going to season with salt and bouillon powder. 2 teaspoons of salt and 4 good teaspoons of bouillon powder. You want the meat to start to absorb that seasoning. I'm just going to stir, cover it, let that cook while I grind the spices. So I have all my spices here except the hot peppers because I don't want the spicy, and these spices are going to make it a little spicy anyway. I'm going to blend everything into a smooth paste. I'm going to add this goodness into the pot, and that's what's going to make our pepper soup. I told you guys, really easy. Right now we're just going to wait for the meat to get tender. I'm going to rinse this. I'm going to add the peppers whole. They are going to add flavor to the soup, but they will not make the soup so spicy. So I'm going to take out the hot peppers because I don't want them to burst. As they cook in the soup, they tend to soften, and if they cook in there too long, they are going to burst and they are going to make the whole soup spicy, and I don't want that because I want my kids to be able to enjoy the soup. At this point, I'm also going to taste and adjust the seasoning as needed. Mmm, so good. Needs more salt. Another teaspoon of salt. Then I'll add the ground white pepper. This is going to give it a really good flavor. Check the meat for doneness. I want it to be nice and tender. So I'm taking this big piece of oxtail. I'm going to cut. You see? Ooh, that feels good. So my knife is cutting it easily. That tells me that it's good. See that? That is good. Our soup is ready, so the heat turns off. Then I'm going to ladle some of this into my bowl here. It smells amazing. I wish you could smell this. Just different chunks of beef. That's why I love to mix, you know, the meat in my pepper soup. It makes it more interesting. Why have only one kind of meat when you can have more than one? I'm going to get some oxtail. Make sure I get everything into this bowl. Get some cow. Beef feet or foot cow. And if I'm serving this for someone who likes pepper, I'll just top it with the pepper that we cooked in the soup so the person can press it into the soup to make it spicy. So I garnished the soup with some chopped Thai basil and some parsley just to make it look pretty. Okay, and for pictures. So I'm going to go in there because I'm hungry. Mmm. Seasoning is perfect. The combination of herbs and spices just gives it this very hearty taste. Is very just very flavorful. Going to get some meat. It's nice and tender. It's so good. I cannot wait to just sit down and cozy up with a bowl of pepper soup. Okay friends, that's how you make delicious Cameroonian pepper soup. Thank you guys so much for spending time with me. For the full recipe, go to my blog preciouscore.com. If you've not subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, please take a minute and hit that subscribe button and also click follow on my Facebook page. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Now I'm going to answer some commonly asked questions about pepper soup. Yes, you can make pepper soup without njangsa. Njangsa can be really hard to find. I get it from African stores. Sometimes I just ask friends for it. But if you can't find njangsa, also you can get it on Amazon. But if you can't find njangsa, still go ahead and make pepper soup without njangsa. You're still going to get a really nice brothy soup that would taste good. It's going to be missing the unique taste of njangsa and the creaminess, but it's still going to be good. You can use many spices in your pepper soup. Many spices and herbs can be added to your soup. Try adding other spices like some thyme, some rosemary, throwing some bay leaf. Sometimes I throw in some bay leaves. You could also add spices like some cumin, some cloves, and you could add the more traditional spices like a little bit of country onions, a little bit of what is called bush pepper. It's like black pepper, but it has a more intense flavor. So you could add different spices and herbs to your pepper soup. Feel free to experiment and see what works for you. You can serve pepper soup with boiled plantains, boiled yam. You could even serve it with rice. Guess what? My husband loves it with bread. It can go with so many sides and you can eat it just by itself. Let me know below, what would you serve pepper soup with? If you have any other questions about making pepper soup, feel free to leave them below and I'll answer them.